You create with your intention. We are in agreement with so many other beings and collectives in the higher realms regarding your ascension progress. And we are also in agreement with what the level of our involvement should be and how to assist without interfering. What we can state with certainty is that the level of consciousness on your world at present is higher than it has ever been. It may be that when viewing your world, you may wonder how that can be, given that people are still engaging in acts of violence, with hate for one another and holding very racist beliefs. These are examples of the lower vibrational consciousness that still exists on your world. However, your overall level of consciousness is the total sum of all the higher thoughts, beliefs, feelings, and actions, placed together with all the lower vibrational consciousness. What this really means is that those of you who are conscious and awake are taking the rest of humanity up with you into the higher realms, into the fifth density frequency range. This was always the plan for your ascension. This was always the plan there on planet Earth. You were always meant to be the ones doing the majority of the work on raising the level of consciousness for all of humanity. And you may ask why that is so. Source, and everyone there who is an individuated representation of Source, all want variety and diversity so much more than sameness, as it is a much bigger feat to attain unity consciousness when there are those who are operating in that low vibrational level of consciousness. You also get to experience what it is like to lift those human beings up through the tractor beam of your love and light, and that is an experience worth having. It is an experience that is so worth having that you would be willing to create the chaos and the terrible circumstances that exist there on your world, in many corners of the earth. This is your time to not only rise up, but also to take so many with you, then feel the feelings that come along with being of service in the most profound way. And yes, we are speaking directly to you as a member of the Awakened Collective. You are doing your contribution by just being in that higher level of consciousness and holding a higher vibration that you have been able to attain in this lifetime. We are sharing with you that it is enough, you are enough, and you are doing enough. So now go and relax so that you can vibrate even higher. We enjoy sharing these messages and the process of seeing who each of you are that are receiving these messages, while observing what each person will do with these messages. We want you to know that every single day that you receive transmission of energy through these messages, that you have been given much more than just words, concepts, ideas, and teachings. When you tune into these energies, you will know the work you have done and what more you may need to do. If you tune into yourself, you can also feel that you are more capable than you were the last time that you tuned into yourself, in the way that you can handle the energies, and the way you can do something positive with them. What is important is what you do with what you have been given in life. In other words, this life is all about what you do with what you have chosen for this life. You knew what you were entering into because you saw it. You looked down the timeline you were about to inhabit. You saw who your parents would be, who your siblings and best friends and so on would be. However, you did not know what you would do with the life. This part is not foreseeable, and it cannot be predicted because there is free will. You have free will, which allows you to choose what you do with what you are given. That free will is precious. It is a gift, and it is one that you start to utilize the moment that you wake up to the truth that you are creating all of this with more than just your thoughts, words, and actions. You are creating all of this with your intentions, your choices, your vibration, and where you place your focus. You are creating all of this with energy, and whenever you have more energy upon you, there is more that you can create. There is more that you can do now because you have so many energies that you are receiving that you can work with. There is so much more that you can accomplish from where you are, and we are prompting you to focus with more intention because we know what you are capable of. We know what your potential is. We know what you can do with the energies that are now upon you and that are coming in, and we encourage you to have that same faith within yourselves. Believe in yourselves and what you can do with your lives and for all of humanity, and you will be a part of the evolution of consciousness in a very real, pragmatic, and practical way, because now you know you are working with more than just natural resources. You are now working with more energy than ever before in human history. And to work with energy, you must first feel for it. Feel for it around you. Feel for it when you breathe. Feel it coming in through the crown of your head, and then direct it with your focus. Ask yourself, what is it that you wish to create? What is it that you wish to see more of on your world? And what types of changes would you like to see in your relationships, finances, and with your health? Focus while also being aware of these energies, and then see what you co-create with this beautiful universe of ours. Let go of the hurt that many people are carrying within themselves, as this hurt becomes resentment, anger, and hate for others that you may feel are responsible for whatever it is that is hurting you. This leads to all sorts of problems in an individual's life, manifesting in a variety of ways, such as health or financial issues, relationship issues, or all of the above. All problems stem from the initial feeling of being hurt by someone else and by not being able to get the love that is at the core of each and every one of us. The love that is at your core can be felt when you fall in love with someone else. And while you may start a relationship with that person in love, eventually the hurt that normally obscures that love will return, and it will surface so that it can be explored within that relationship. To heal those wounds that you accumulate within you over the years, even decades of being hurt by others, is a process. Remember the tools for transformation. Recognize, validate, feel, and choose again. Firstly, it helps if you can recognize through spiritual awakening that you planned to be hurt by that other person or by those people. If you can recognize that it was an agreement, that there was a contract involved, and that you signed the contract, then you come to a place of acceptance. If you can accept what happened, and accept how you feel about it with all the repercussions, it is then that you can come to a place of forgiveness. When you forgive others for what you feel they did or said to you, you release so much in that moment, which has prevented you from being the love that you truly are at all times. Many of you who are awake still hold on to your resentments, anger, and judgments of those who you feel have hurt you and those who hurt others, and we are gently reminding you that everything that you have experienced in the early part of your life was planned. It was orchestrated by you and with all others who were involved to give you a certain experience. Those experiences are necessary for everyone to decide voluntarily to release that which is a burden, that which has been holding them back, through their free will. In order to be able to accept and forgive, first you must have an offense, and that can be very hard for people to recognize. It is difficult remembering your setup and blueprint for this life. Therefore, it falls upon us and collectives like ourselves to share with you that everything that has happened to you was by agreement, and you were a part of that agreement. When you really understand this, you then have a choice about whether you will continue to see yourself as a victim, or whether you can accept yourself as a co-creator. When you are a co-creator, You can forgive yourself and everyone else involved in the co-creation that resulted from carrying the hurt or hurts within you for so long. Forgiveness is freeing, it is liberating, and it allows you to start anew in your life. When you are starting fresh, without all the trauma and all those wounds, imagine what you can become. Imagine how much love you can access, and how much of that love you can share and spread around. And know that when you do, you are accessing your true power. You are then placing yourself in a position where you can create such a beautiful life for yourself and others who are a part of your life. This is what we desire for all of you, and is why we give you a reminder of the power of forgiveness and the truth of who you are as eternal and infinite beings who existed before this incarnation and who will continue to exist forever and evermore. Only very powerful beings would ever agree to be as vulnerable as you are, and to allow yourselves to be victims of any kind of abuse. It is time to claim your power, and the path to claiming it is by letting go and forgiving all who you feel have hurt you to this point in your life. Once you do, just imagine what you can be and what you can create. We are sharing with you what we discovered once we ascended into the non-physical, and that is to be light-hearted and to approach other beings and collectives in the galaxy and universe in a playful way. The experience we have of joy is something that you can also look forward to in your ascension. Your life can be fun, playful, full of joy, laughter, and excitement with regards with what is to come. It does not all have to be serious. Even though there are serious things happening on Earth which draws your attention from time to time, that you cannot avoid hearing about or reading about on your phone or computer screen, remember that you are there to be the light in the face of the darkness. And therefore, as you seek the light-hearted approach, you find yourself then becoming a match to lighter and better feeling news. You will find yourself aligning with a reality where there is less evidence of the darkness. Remember that you are always vibrating, and what you vibrate will determine what you experience. Therefore, search for ways to have fun, make light of your situation, your challenges, and those people who also wish to take the same path will be drawn to you. There are many who want spirituality to be more fun and less serious. Therefore, it is advisable to listen to those people, rather than following people who consistently give you doom and gloom reports, because you think that you need to stay informed to be protected. The only thing you ever need protection from is your own vibration, which you have complete control over. The moment you recognize that you have complete control over your own vibration, you can move towards the light. You can move to that higher vibrational state. Many of you know how to do that, and some of you are still remembering. And that process is worth giving your attention to. Consider children at play. They want to play, they want to have fun, they want to laugh. They are not interested in staying informed, but they still manage to find ways to make something into a game or toy. There is much to learn from watching them and of how creative they are. A child laughing is one of the best sounds you can possibly experience there on Earth. Therefore, join them in their carefree nature, their playful approach, and know that they are there to teach you, just as we are, and they are teaching you about how to take the lighter and more joyous path through life. We are here to remind you that you are creating the path, and you create the path with joy. You can expect more joy, more joyous experiences, and more joyful people to come into your life the moment you make a decision to be more light-hearted, to be fun, and to laugh more. We know that you can do this while still having many opportunities to be of service to the collective and do your spiritual work. You will not be missing any of those opportunities. But you always have the option to create more opportunities to experience yourself as a light-hearted being of joy, love, and laughter. There are still predictions about the completion of the shift, as people like to get ahead of themselves because it feels very good to go to that place. And many individuals will accept those predictions as truth. However, you are meant to have many more experiences there in the fourth density before you complete the shift to the fifth density, as those experiences serve you very well as a fifth density being. You are, however, getting closer to full and open extraterrestrial contact, and we see many of you interested in preparing for that contact. What you are doing in those moments of preparation is you are solidifying your place on the timeline where it occurs in the very near future. You are showing faith. It is important that everyone who wants extraterrestrial contact understands that this is not a savior scenario. This is not a time where ETs come in and solve all humanity's problems. We are talking about beings who will get your attention for a variety of reasons. While you may be curious and excited to look on board a starship and fly around in, what is of more importance to the evolution of consciousness of every single human being is what ETs will emanate and how they will teach you. You have much to share with them, and they have much to share with you, and we are all more powerful when we are united. They want to experience the power of unification of the galaxy, with humans of Earth being a part of the galactic community, but not before you are ready. Therefore, you must be patient also and recognize that you can still have your own ET contact experiences while you wait. Continue preparing yourselves for face-to-face contact and ships landing across the planet, and continue to cleanse yourself of everything that is dark and heavy that is no longer serving you, so that your face-to-face meeting with one of your ET friends will be as an equal, as someone who is feeling their worthiness to have that engagement. And you can let go of that idea that they are only coming to save us all from ourselves. You are the ones who are leading humanity in this consciousness evolution, and you will be the ones who take to the teachings best, and you will spread them to your fellow humans, who will accept or not accept those teachings, depending on where they are. However, we know that enough people will be in acceptance of those teachings to make a huge difference in the overall collective consciousness of humanity. And that is what it will take to complete the shift in consciousness. Being aware of ourselves and aware of our relationship to all other beings and collectives in this vast universe of ours, we know what our purpose is with regards to every single other being and collective, which is a good feeling to have within ourselves. We have ascended to the ninth density, a frequency range that makes it easier for us to hold that awareness within us, and we understand it is more difficult for you to hold that awareness in the fourth density. Often you do not recognize how you are supposed to relate to someone else from day to day, or those who are more permanent in your lives. We suggest you ask yourselves, who am I to this person or this group, and who are they to me? It is helpful to understand your relationship with others, what that relationship is all about, and that it is okay to relate to someone or group of people from a distance. Sometimes you must make hard choices and decide for yourselves what is most appropriate concerning other people in your lives. If you are growing, expanding, and evolving at a faster pace than someone else, and you can feel that it is time to say goodbye or distance yourself from that person in some way, then that is what you must do. However, the other person may not really want to experience that separation or distance. In a romantic relationship, the partner may not want to experience the breakup, but that may be because you are vibrating at a higher frequency, and they are attracted to you and that higher vibration of energy that you hold within you. Sometimes you must set boundaries with people in order to maintain that higher vibration, because they will seek as much of your time and attention as they can, for they have not yet discovered that they have the power within themselves to vibrate at a higher frequency. Even if you love that person, you can always love them from a comfortable distance. You can send them love. You can feel compassion. You can hold space for them to get what they need so that they can start vibrating at a higher frequency and join you in that higher frequency range. You can never completely remove someone from your life because they will always exist inside of you. And when you have a relationship with someone else that feels powerful at any time, you can rest assured you will be together again when you are on the same wavelength. We share this with you because of how important it is for you to maintain that higher vibration for the entire collective. You are doing so much more for all of humanity than you were ever doing for one or two individuals. Remember to take care of yourselves, set healthy boundaries, and trust your feelings, as they will always tell you whether someone is a match to you or not. Te wāna, tāua, te awa.